usus ilma kahtlemata, sest kahtleja sarnaneb tuule tõstetud sinna tänna ja paisatud merelainetega.
And so when you're praying, when you're asking God for something,
kui sina palud Jumalat, kui sina küsid midagi Jumala käest,
it's about where your heart is in the asking that determines whether you receive.
Siis see, kas sa saad vastu võtta või mitte, see oleneb sellest, et kas sul on usku.
And it says that when we pray that we need to believe and not doubt.
Ja Piibel räägib, kui me palume Jumalalt, siis me peaksime uskuma, mitte kahtlema.
Because if you have any doubt,
sest kui sul on mingisuguski kahtlust,
the devil can come and he can steal what it is that you're believing God for.
Siis saatan saab tulla ja röövida selle ära, mille iganes suhtes sul usku on Jumalas.
I've asked for things from God before and I had doubt in my heart.
Ma olen küsinud Jumala käest asju, mille suhtes mul on kahtlusi olnud.
I wasn't sure if God would do it, but it sure would be nice if he did.
Ma ei olnud kindel, kas Jumal võib seda minu jaoks teha või mitte, aga oleks tore, kui ta saaks teha.
Wow, it'd sure be great if God would come and do this for us.
Küll oleks tore, kui Jumal teeks midagi sellist meie jaoks.
I don't know how that would ever happen.
Aga ma ei tea, kuidas see võiks üldse kuidagi juhtuda.
You know, you're having these conversations on the inside.
Sul sees toimuvad sellised vestlused.
And your prayer is, Lord, we're expecting you to show up.
Ja sinu palve on see, et Jumal, me ootame, et sa ilmutaksid ennast siin.
But on the inside you're going, man, I don't know if it's going to happen.
Aga oma sisemuses sa mõtled, et mina küll ei tea, mis siin toimuma saab.
And you know, that's when the devil can come so easily.
Ja sellistel hetkedel saatan saab väga kergesti sisse lipsata.
And start to talk you out of what you're believing God for.
Ja hakata siin ümber veenma selle suhtes, mida sa oled uskunud Jumalalt.
Say, oh no, you'll never have that.
Ja öelda, et see ei saa sul kunagi olema.
That's only for other people.
See on ainult teistel inimestel.
You know, you're not holy enough to walk in those blessings. What
tead,
are you talking about?
Sina ei ole piisavalt püha, et kõndida nende sõnistuses, mis Jumal neile inimestel on.
God's too busy to deal with you right now anyway.
Et Jumalal on liiga palju tegemist selleks, et sinuga üldse tegeleda praegu.
You're getting all these thoughts that are just bombarding you, and if you've got doubt in your heart, you're going to say, well, yeah, that's what I thought.
Ja siis kõik need kahtlused tulevad ja siis ületel sa mõtlek, okei, aga nii ma arvasingi, et nii juhtub.
I figured that's the way it was going to be anyway. I'm not really expecting to get anything.
Et ma tegelikult ei ootagi Jumala käest midagi, et ma teadsin, et nii kunigi Jumal ei tee mitte midagi.
And that's what James is saying here. He's saying you're like the waves of the sea. You're just going to be blown around by whatever thought comes.
Ja seda Jakobus mõtlebki, et sa oled nagu merelaine, mida paisatakse ühele poole ja teisele poole.
But we are to have our faith on the rock.
Aga meie usk peaks toetuma kaljule.
Not be blown by any winds.
Mis ei tohiks olla nii-öelda paisatud tuule poolt.
We're to put our faith in God knowing that he's going to come through.
Me peaksime panema oma usu ja lootuse Jumala peale teades, et ta toob meid läbi.
And as we keep reading with verse 7,
ja kui me loeme 7. salmist edasi,
it talks about the person that is blown by the winds.
Et rääkides nendest inimestest, keda tuul paiskab ühele ja teisele poole.
It says that person should not expect to receive anything from the Lord.
Et selline inimene ärgu ometi arvaku, et ta midagi.
And how many know that's true? I know that's true for me.
Ma tean, et minu puhul on see kehtiv.
When I'm kind of like, oh, I don't know, I never get it.
Kui mina olen kahel, on niimoodi, et ma olen, et ei tea, kas ikka saab või mitte, ja ma ei ole kunagi saanud seda, mida ma olen palunud.
But it goes on to say, this such a person is double-minded and unstable in all that they do.
Ja siin edaspidi ütleb, et ta on hingelt kaksipidi mees, ebakindel kõigil oma teedel.
So not only is it saying we don't get what we ask for.
Nii et siin mitte ainult ei ütle, et me ei saa seda, mida me palusime.
The Bible tells us that we become unstable.
Vaid Piibel ütleb, et me muutume ebastabiilseks.
In everything.
Kõiges.
No, I don't think that means that we're, you know, those people just go crazy. I don't think that's what it's talking about.
Ma ei usu, et siin on mõeldud seda, et sa muutud, lähed hulluks. Ma ei usu, et see Piibel ütleb seda.
But it's talking about the prayer of faith.
Aga ta räägib siin usupalvest.
It's talking about men and women of faith.
Siin räägib usumeestest ja naistest.
And we become unstable in our faith when we don't trust in our God.
Ja kui me ei usalda oma Jumalat, siis me muutume oma usus ebastabiilseks.
And so we need to believe and not doubt.
Ja meil on vaja uskuda ja mitte kahelda.
When you pray,
kui sa palvetad,
believe God can do what it is that he promised he would do.
Siis usu, et Jumal teeb seda, mida ta tõotas teha.
And sometimes it takes crazy faith to do that.
Ja vahet selleks, et seda saavutada, sul on tõesti hullumeelset usku vaja.
Faith that doesn't make sense in the natural.
Usku, mis loomulikuses ei tundu loogiline.
Can God heal my body?
Kas Jumal tõesti võib teha minu ihu terveks?
When this medicine can't?
Kui see rohi isegi ei saa mind teha terveks.
I mean, that takes some radical faith to believe that God is a healer.
Et uskuda, et Jumal on tõesti meie tervendaja, see nõuab radikaalset usku.
That takes some faith that says, I believe God can do anything.
See nõuab sellist usku, et sa tõesti usud, et Jumal suudab teha kõike.
When you're having problems in a home and in your marriage.
Kui sul on kodus või peres on probleeme.
And then you say, but I believe God can help us to get through this.
Aga sa ütled, et aga ma usun, et Jumal toob meid läbi sellest.
Even though it looks like it's going nowhere.
Va- vaatamata sellele, et paistab nagu me ei jõuaks mitte kuskile.
I believe God can help us take this somewhere.
Ja ma usun, et Jumal saab viia meid kusagile.
We can do this together.
Ja et me võime teha seda ühes koos.
That is the kind of faith it's going to take.
Sellist usku on tarvis.
To have a success in your life.
Selleks, et sul võiks elus olla mingisugune edu.
Have health in your body.
Et sinu elus saaks olla tervis.
To have success in your marriage.
Et sul oleks edukas abielu.
So that your future is better than your present.
Et sinu tulevik saaks olla parem kui sinu praegune olukord.
And that's what God desires for each and every one of us.
Ja see on miski, mida Jumal igatseb iga ühe meie jaoks.
That our future is better than our now.
Et meie tulevik on parem kui meie praegune olukord.
No matter how good you might feel now.
Vaatamata sellele, kuivõrd hästi sa ka ennast praegu ei tunne.
I believe that God has got bigger and better for you.
Ma usun, et Jumalal on suuremaid ja paremaid asju varuks sinu jaoks.
So God wants us to receive from him.
Jumal tahab, et me võtaksime vastu tema käest.
And he is instructing us in his word on how we can receive.
Ja ta on juhendanud meid läbi oma sõna, kuidas me saame vastu võtta.
And we need to use our faith.
Ja selleks meil on vaja kasutada usku.
Because if you're not in faith,
kui sina ei ole usus,
the Bible says that God can't come through for you.
Siis Piibel ütleb, et Jumal ei saa siin nendest asjadest läbi tuua.
You shouldn't expect to receive anything if you're not believing God when you pray.
Et kui sina ei usu Jumalalt, et ta saab tõesti siin läbi tuua, kui sa palud, siis ta ei saa siin tuua läbi.
Because your doubt and your unbelief can block God from being able to move for you.
Sest sinu kahtlused ja uskmatus saab tak Jumala tegutsemist sinu elus.
But when we ask in faith,
aga kui me palume usus,
we believe that God will come through.
Ja usume, et Jumal tõesti toob meid läbi.
We don't have any doubt to the thoughts that come.
Et meil ei ole mingisuguseid kahtlusi nende mõtete suhtes, mis tulevad.
Because the same thoughts are always going to come.
Sest alati tulevad need samad mõtted.
But it's the question of where you are in your heart.
Aga küsimus on selles, et kus kohas sina oled oma südames.
Are you sure in your heart that God promised?
Kas sa oled oma südames veendunud, et Jumal tõotas?
And then the thoughts that come, you just say, no, that's not true.
Ja siis sa saad öelda nendele mõtetele, mis tulevad, kuule, et ei, see ei ole nii.
Or are you kind of double-minded, kind of, yeah, I hope so, but I really don't know.
Või sa niimoodi ei suuda otsustada oma mõttes, et kas sa nüüd usud seda või ei usu, et kas ma tõesti usun, et ma saan terveks või ma ei tea ka, mis nüüd saab.
If that's where you're at,
kui see on see koht, kus sina oled,
I guarantee you the devil's going to fight and those thoughts are going to steal your faith.
Ja siis ma garanteerin sulle, et saatan võitleb selle nimel ja ta saab võidu lõpuks.
And so it's the name of Jesus that we need to hold on to as our anchor for life.
Meil on vaja Jeesuse nimest kinni hoida kui ankur meie elu jaoks.
It's the name of Jesus that is going to give us strength.
Jeesuse nimi, mis annab meile tugevust.
It's the name of Jesus that's going to give us the power to go on to that next thing.
See on Jeesuse nimi, mis aitab meil edasi jõuda uuele tasemele oma elus.
Because we know it's in the name that he can provide everything that he promised to us.
Me teame, et selle nime läbi tema saab varustada meid kõigiga, mis me vajame.
And so there's going to be times that you're going to need to fight to receive the promises of God.
Nii et on aegu, kus sa pead võitlema selle nimel, et vastu võtta neid tõotusi, mis Jumala sõnas on pandud.
Just as Paul said, and we read this last time, that Paul said, I fought the good fight of faith.
Nagu me eelmine kord lugesime, et Paulus rääkis, et ta võitles head usu võitlus.
I fought this fight. I've accomplished what it is that I believe God set before me.
Ta võitles ja ta saavutas selle eesmärgi, mis Jumal tema silmet oli pannud.
And when you're fighting the good fight of faith,
ja kui sina võitled head usu võitlust.
What is a good fight?
Ja siis, mis on hea võitlus?
A good fight is one that you win, right?
Hea võitlus on see, mille sina võidad, Anni.
You know, when you've had a good fight, when everything's gone well, that means you've won.
Et kui sina oled läbi tulnud ühest heast võitlusest, siis tähendab, et sa oled olnud võidukas.
And so Paul, what he's saying is, I've won the battles by faith.
Ja mida Paulus ütleb, et on see, et ma olen võitnud need läbi usu.
My God has come through for me every time.
Minu Jumal on mind läbi toonud absoluutselt igal korral.
Because I believe.
Sest mina uskus.
I didn't doubt.
Ma ei kahelnud.
I put my trust in him.
Ma panin oma usalduse temale.
And look at everything I've been able to do with my life.
Ja vaata, mida ma olen saavutanud oma eluga.
And Paul loved his life.
Ja Paulus armastas oma elu.
Other people would look at Paul's life and say, that's not a life I ever want to live.
Teised inimesed võisid vaadata Pauluse elu peale ja mõelda, et kuule, ma küll sellist elu ei tahaks.
But Paul saw a bigger picture.
Aga Paulus nägi suuremat pilti oma elu
läbi. He wasn't looking at the short-term goals.
Ta ei keskendunud nendele lühiajalistele tulemustele.
But he looked at it as I've got an opportunity to start many churches.
Ma ta vaatas selle peale, et mul on suur võimalus
to start many churches.
Alustada paljusid uusi kogudusi.
He said, I've had the opportunity to preach the gospel in places that never even heard of Jesus.
Ütles, et mul oli võimalus te jagada Jumala sõna kohtades, kus keegi on Jeesus nimest kuulnudki.
I've seen thousands of people give their lives to him.
Nägi, kuidas tuhanded inimesed said päästetud tema abiga.
I've been able to write letters to strengthen each one of these congregations.
Et ta sai kirjutada kirju erinevatele kogudustele.
And I am not done yet.
Ja ta ei olnud veel lõpetanud.
I mean, Paul, he was a man who had some trust that God would use him to do great things.
Paulus oli mees, kellel oli suur usk selles, mida Jumal saab teha tema elus.
And being in prison and being beat and going through hardships never stopped him.
Ja kõik see, et ta pandi vangi, et ta peksti läbi vahepeal mitu korda ja et ta läks erinevatest raskustest läbi, see ei takistanud teda.
Every time he said, I just put my faith in God and I got the victory.
Igal korral ta ütles, et ma panin oma usalduse Jumalale ja ma tulin läbi.
Every time I came through better.
Iga kord ma tulin tugevana ja paremana välja.
Every time God used my situation to cause my words to be even more powerful.
Iga kord Jumal kasutas mind, et minu sõnad oleksid veel väelisemad nendes paikades.
And so he fought the fight of faith.
Ja ta võitles headuse võitlust.
And you're going to have to stand up at times and you're going to have to fight that fight of faith just like Paul and just like everybody else.
Ja nagu kus sa pead nii-öelda püsti tõusma ja tõesti võitlema neid võitlusi nagu Pauluski pidi.
And you're going to have to stand up and fight for what it is that God has given to you.
Ja sa pead seisma ja võitlema nende asjade nimel, mis Jumal on sulle annud.
Fight for your family.
Võitled oma perekonna eest.
Fight for the ministry that God has called you.
Võitled selle teenistuse eest, millesse Jumal on sind kutsunud.
Fight for your job.
Võitled oma töökoha nimel.
Fight for your future.
Võitled oma tuleviku nimel.
You know, we are to fight for the promises of God.
Me peaksime võitlema nende tõotuste nimel, mis Jumal oma sõna läbi on andnud.
And whatever it is that you need in your life, whatever it might be lacking, there is a promise.
Ja mida iganes sul on elus vaja, mis iganes see puudujääk sinu elus on, sellele on tõotus olemas.
So you find the promise and you believe that that is for you.
Nii sa leiad selle tõotuse ja siis sa usud, et see kuulub sulle.
Knowing that God is going to come through no matter what.
Sa tead, et Jumal toob sind läbi vaatamata kõikidele muudele asjadele.
And we have to fight sometimes to stay in that place of faith in God.
Ja vahest me peame tõsiselt võitlema selle nimel, et jääda sellesse paika Jumalaga.
You know, the Bible says our fight is not with people.
Et Biblia ütleb, et meil ei tule võidelda inimestega.
Your fight is not with your boss.
Sinu võitlus ei ole sinu ülemusega.
To get more money.
Et saada rohkem raha.
You know that he's not your enemy.
Tema ei ole sinu vaenlane.
You know your fight is not with others that stand in your way to get your blessings.
Sinu vaenlaseks ei ole teised inimesed, kes seisavad tee peal ees, et sa ei saa neid õnnistusi kätte.
What is our fight?
Milles seisneb meie võitlus?
Our fight is to stay in faith.
Meie võitlus seisneb selles, et me jääme usku.
Our fight is to fill ourselves with the word of God so that we are not moved when the thoughts of doubt come.
Meie võitlus seisneb selles, et me täidame ennast Jumala sõnaga, et me saame olla tugevad, kui need katsumused tulevad.
And know that a thought of doubt does not mean you have doubt in your heart.
Ja tea, et see, kui sul tuleb mingisugune kahtlus või ja kahtlema paneb mõte, lihtsalt see mõte ei tähenda, et see kaksipidine.
Because everybody has thoughts of doubt.
Sest meil kõigil on kahtluse mõtteid.
I'm sure whatever it is that you're believing God for, there's been a thought that says, are you sure?
Ma olen kindel, et mida iganes sa oled Jumala käest uskunud, alati on mingisugune mõte tulnud, et oled sa ikka kindel.
And that's where we need to stand and we need to say yes because he promised.
Aga need on need kohad, kus me peame seisma jääma ja ütleme, et jah, ma usun seda, sellepärast, et niimoodi on tõotud.
And it's not about me, it's about him and his faithfulness to his word.
Ja see ei seisne minus, vaid Jumala ustavuses jääda kindlaks oma sõnas.
And that's why we need to know his word.
Ja sellepärast meil on vaja teada ja tunda tema sõna.
So that we can quote the word over our life, over our situation.
Ja me saaksime tsiteerida nii-öelda Jumala sõna enda elu üle ja teiste olukord, teiste inimeste üle.
That we can quote the word of God over our future, knowing that God's going to meet me there and it's going to be good.
Tsiteerida Jumala sõna oma tuleviku suhtes ja uskuda ja loota seda, et Jumal kohtub meiega seal.
And so, you know, I've had to, you know, just like all you, I've had to fight for times in my life.
Täpselt samamoodi minu elus on olnud võitlusi, kus ma olen pidanud võitlema erinevates olukordades.
There's been lots of times that I've gone through difficulties.
On paljusid olukordi olnud, kus ma olen läinud raskustest läbi.
Where things didn't look like the promises that I read in the Bible.
Kus asjaolud ei tundunud üldsegi liigi läheselgi sarnased olema Jumala sõna tõotustele.
This God of abundance and you're thinking, where's the abundance?
Sa mõtled, et ma teenin küll küllusliku Jumalat, aga ma küll mingisugust küllust ei näe.
And when the promises seem far off.
Ja kui need tõotused tunduvad sinust kaugle olevat.
And maybe you've made some foolish mistakes in your life.
Kus sa võib-olla oled oma elus teinud rumalaid otsuseid.
I know I've made some foolish mistakes.
Mina tean, mina olen kindlasti teinud kõvasti rumalaid otsuseid.
I'm not perfect.
Ma ei ole täiuslik.
And so there's times that it seems like it's so far away from what God said it would be.
Ja on olnud aegu, kus tundub nagu asjaolud oleksid kõvasti kaugel sellest, mis Jumal on tõotanud.
You know, I need God to come through for me.
Et mul on vaja, et Jumal tooks mind läbi.
Something supernatural needs to happen or you know, I don't know what to do.
Kuule, selles olukorras peab midagi üleloomulikku lihtsalt juhtuma, sest muidu ma ei tea, mis edasi saab.
Man, I've fought my battles.
Ma olen oma lahinguid võidelnud.
And I've seen God come through for me.
Ja ma olen näinud, kuidas Jumal on olnud ustav oma sõnale.
I hope that you can say the same, that the battles that you have fought, you've seen God come through for you.
Ma usun, et ka sina saad oma elus öelda, et sa oled näinud, kuidas Jumal on olnud ustav erinevatest võitlustest, mis sul on olnud.
Because he's done so much for us.
Sest ta on nii palju teinud meie jaoks.
He's done so much for people in this country that they don't even understand yet what he's done.
Jumal on teinud niivõrd palju asju inimestele, kes on siin selles riigis ja inimesed ei mõistagi, mida Jumal on teinud.
And when we know that God has given us the battle.
Ja kui me teame, et Jumal on meile annud selle lahingu nii-öelda võidu.
When we know that he's given us the victory.
Me teame, et ta on annud meile selle võidu.
Then we're going to be able to stand on what belongs to me in Christ Jesus.
Me saame seista selle eest, mis me teame, et Kristuses Jeesuses kuulub meile.
This is not because I am a good person.
Ta asi ei ole selles, et mina olen hea inimene.
It's because he's perfect.
Oi, ta asi on selles, et Jumal on täiuslik.
It's not because I am worthy of anything, but it's because he has made me worthy.
Asi ei ole selles, et mina olen isenesest kuidagi väärt seda, vaid Jumal on teinud mind olema väärt seda.
He went to the cross so that I could rise.
Jumal läks ristile, et mina võiksin tõusta.
And that is the promise of God to each and every one of you.
Ja see on see tõotus, mis Jumal on andnud igal ühele teist.
And so I've you know, we all have to fight.
Meil kõigil on vaja võidelda.
And I want to look here tonight at a woman in Matthew chapter 9.
Me tahan vaadata ühe naise elu peale Matteuse evangeeliumi 9. peatükis.
This is a story that we've looked at many times before.
See on üks lugu, mida me oleme mitmeid kordi varemgi uurinud.
But this is a woman who was in a fight.
Aga siin on lugu ühest naisest, kes oli võitluses.
And she was in the fight of faith.
Ja ta oli keset usu võitlus.
She was in the fight for what she believed that the anointing of Jesus could do for her.
Ta oli võitluses selle nimel, mida ta uskus, et Jeesuse vägi saab teha tema elus.
And in Matthew chapter 9, starting with verse 20.
Ja Matteuse 9. peatükki 20. salmist.
And it said, and just then a woman who had been subject to bleeding for 12 years came up behind him and touched the edge of his cloak.
Matteuse 9:20. Ja vaata, üks naine, kes oli olnud veritõves 12 aastat, tuli ta selja taha ja puudutas ta huue valitust.
And she said to herself, if I could only touch his cloak, I'm going to be healed.
Sest naine mõtles endamisi, kui ma ainult saaksin puudutada tema kuube, siis ma pääseksin.
And Jesus turned and saw her and take heart, daughter, he said, your faith has healed you, and the woman was healed at that moment.
Aga Jeesus pöördus ja sõnas teda nähes, tütar ole julge, sinu usk on su päästnud ja naine sai terveks sel samal hetkel.
And so we see here a woman who fought to get to Jesus because she knew if I could just get there, I'll receive.
Ja siin on lugu naises, kes võitles selle nimel, et jõudi Jeesuseni, sest ta teadis, et kui ta jõuab temani, siis ta saab lahendus oma probleemile.
And so I want you to see, it's not just what she believed in her heart.
Ma tahan, et sa näeksid seda, et asja ei seisnud ainult selles, mida ta oma südames uskus.
But she accompanied what she believed with action.
Vaid sellele lisaks, mida ta uskus, ta pani ka teod juurde.
She went and took what belonged to her.
Ta läks ja võttis vastu selle, mis te teadis, et kuulub temale.
She knew that if I could just get to Jesus, there's healing there for me.
Ja ta teadis, et kui mina joon Jeesuse juurde, siis seal on tervenemine ja tervis minule.
If I could just touch his cloak, I'm going to be healed.
Mul piisab ainult sellest, et ma saan tema riide tükki puudutada ja ma saan terveks.
And she didn't just believe it, but then she began to confess it.
Ja ta mitte üksnes ei uskunud seda, vaid ta hakkas ka tunnistama seda.
She began to speak the word over herself.
Ta hakkas rääkima seda sõna oma elu üle.
Because the Bible said that when the Messiah comes, there's going to be healing in the edge of his garment.
Sest Biiblis oli, Jumala sõnas oli öeldud, et kui Messias tuleb, siis tema kuue servades on tervenemine ja tervis.
And so she said, I know he is the Messiah. I believe that.
Ja ta ütles ja teadis, et tema on Messias ja ma usun, et ta on Messias.
He's the one who came to save us.
Tema on see, kes tuli meid päästma.
And if I could just get to him and touch him, I know that I can take what is mine.
Kui ma vaid jõuaksin temani ja saaksin puudutada teda, siis ma saan vastu võtta selle, mis kuulub mulle.
And from that very moment, we see that she was healed.
Ja sel samal hetkel me nägime, et ta sai terveks.
And so this woman fought for what belonged to her, and she received.
Et see naine võitles selle nimel,
and she received.
Ta võitles selle nimel, mida tal oli vaja, ja ta võitis selle vastu.
And she got it by faith.
Ja ta sai selle usu läbi.
Amen. Faith in her heart.
Uskus oma südames.
And then faith with her actions to take what was hers.
Ja ta näitas seda ka läbi oma tegude, et ta uskus ja võttis vastu selle.
You know, when God offers you something, when you find a promise in the Bible,
teab, kui Jumal tõotab sulle midagi, kui sa leiab midagi Jumala sõnast,
you need to claim that this is for me.
Sa pead tunnistama, et see on minule.
And you might think that, well, no, it was said to this woman or it was said to that man.
Ja sa võibolla mõtled, et kuule, et aga seda öeldi sellel naisele või sellele mehele.
But no, you need to say, the word of God is for me.
Aga ei, sa pead ütlema, et ei, Jumala sõna on minule.
And so this promise belongs to me.
Nii, et see tõotus kuulub ka minule.
And so you need to take the promise as yours.
Ja sul on vaja võtta see, nii-öelda tunnistada see tõotus ise isiklikuks, ise endale kuuluvaks.
And then you need to claim it.
Ja tunnistama seda.
You need to be speaking that over your life.
Ja pead tunnistama seda ja ütlema seda oma elu üle.
I believe Jesus is my peace.
Ma usun, et Jeesus on minu rahu.
I believe that he gives me wisdom.
Ma usun, et tema annab mulle tarkust.
I believe that I have joy.
Ma usun, et mulle kuulub rõõm.
I believe that I have favor.
Ma usun, et minule kuulub soosing.
Whatever it is that the Bible promises, we claim that for ourselves.
Mis iganes see on, mida Piibel meile tõotab, me tunnistame seda endale kuuluvaks.
And so we believe it,
me usume
claim
seda,
it,
me tunnistame seda
by faith.
Usu läbi.
And then we go and we take it by faith.
Ja siis me läheme ja võtame seda vastu usu läbi.
We put ourselves in a situation that it has to be there.
Me paneme ennast sellisesse olukorda, kus see peab olema seal.
And then we can say thank you for the wisdom I have right now.
Ja siis me saame öelda, et Jumal aitäh sulle selle tarkuse eest, mis mulle kuulub.
Thank you for the favor I have right now.
Jumal tänu sulle soosingu eest, mis kuulub mulle.
Thank you for the joy I have right now.
Jumal aitäh sulle selle rõõmu eest, mis on minul.
When everything around you might look like chaos.
Kui kõik sinu ümber võib tunduda kaos nagu kaos.
You can go take your peace.
Sa võid minna vastu võtta oma rahu.
By faith.
Usu läbi.
Just saying, this is mine, and I take it right now.
Ja öelda, et see kuulub mulle, ja ma võtan selle vastu praegu.
And I'm not going to worry about all this.
Ja ma ei kavatse muretseda nende asjade pärast.
Because I've got my eyes on you.
Sest minu silmad on sinu peal,
and this is the way that we need to live our lives.
Ja see on viis, kuidas me peaksime elama oma elus.
And we need to claim these promises over ourselves and our families.
Me on vaja tunnistada ja kuulutada neid tõotusi enda ja enda perede üle.
Parents can say, God, give me my child.
Et vanemad saavad öelda, et Jumal, ma tänan, et saad annu mulle mu lapse.
Give me my destiny.
Anna mulle minu saatus.
Yeah. Give me my future.
Minu tulevik, et minu tulevik kuulub mulle.
You know, whatever it is that you have for me, I claim that now.
Jumal, mis iganes sul on minu jaoks, ma tunnistan, et see kuulub mulle.
And you need to take it.
Ja sul on vaja see vastu võtta.
You need to pick up the promise and run with it.
Sa pead üles korjama selle tootuse ja jooksma sellega koos.
Not just asking for it.
Mitte lihtsalt paluma seda.
It's not just about praying and say, okay, God, I believe that you died for me and I thank you that you give this to me.
Asi ei ole selles, et sa ainult palud, et Jumal, ma tänan, et sa surid minu eest ja ma tänan, et sa annad selle mulle.
You don't need to make a weird noise because we pray that.
Et sa ei pea kuidagi imelikus.
Okay, no, I was talking to you. All right, we pray that.
Et me palume seda.
But then we need to go and we need to act on that.
Aga siis me peame ka tegutsema vastavalt sellele.
And then we take what belongs to you.
Ja siis me peame vastu võtma selle, mis kuulub sulle.
And we work on that.
Ja me töötame selle nimel.
We make sure that okay, this is not going to be taken from me today.
Ja me teeme kindlaks, et seda asja ei võeta minult ära.
I believe this belongs to me.
Ma usun, et see kuulub mulle.
I prayed and I've asked God.
Ma usun ja ma olen palunud Jumala käest.
And it's not just the prayer, it's the action.
Ja asi ei seisne üksnes selles palves, vaid selles teos, mis sa teed siin.
This is what the Bible calls living by faith.
Ja seda Piibel nimetab usus käimiseks.
It doesn't say that the Bible doesn't say that the church will only pray by faith.
Piibel ei ütle, et kogudus saab palvetama üksnes usus.
The Bible doesn't say that the church will only speak by faith.
Piibel ei ütle, et kogudus ainult räägib usu läbi.
But we are to pray, speak and act by faith.
Vaid me peaksime paluma, rääkima ja tegutsema usus.
Amen. And this is how we receive the promises of God.
Ja seda me võtame vastu Jumala tõotus.
And I want it to become easy for you to receive from God.
Ma tahan, et see oleks lihtne sinu jaoks vastu võtta Jumala käest.
I want it to be easy for you to receive from the Lord.
Ma tahan, et see oleks lihtne sinu vastu võtta Isanda käest.
I want it to be easy for you to receive from other people.
Ma tahan, et see oleks lihtne sinu vastu võtta teiste inimeste käest.
Because how many know when God moves?
Kui palju teavad, et kui Jumal liigub?
99% of the time, he's going to use other people to move for you.
99% olukordades Jumal kasutab teisi inimesi selleks, et liikuda sinu nimel.
And then we don't just thank the people, we need to be thanking God.
Ja me ei peaks tänama üksnes neid inimesi, kes teevad meile asju, vaid Jumalat, kes on nemad saatnud meie
elu. Let me tell you a story.
Ma räägin teile ühe loo.
It's not just a story, it happened in my life.
See ei ole lihtsalt mingisugune lugu, see juhtus minu elus.
But there was a missionary couple that were living here in Estonia many years ago.
Aga üks missionäri paar elas siin riigis, Eestis.
And they were doing the work of God here.
Ja nad tegid siin Jumala tööd.
And they were having some financial difficulties.
Ja neil oli finansilisi raskusi.
And they you know, they told us that they weren't going to be able to stay here in Estonia.
Ja, nad rääksid, et me ei saa jääda siia Eestisse.
And so I felt really bad about it because I saw that they were doing a great work.
Ja ma olin väga kurb, sellepärast ma nägin, et nad tegid väga head tööd siin.
And so, you know, I just prayed and I was praying for them and I was like, God, I just pray that you come through for them.
Ja ma lihtsalt palutasin enda pärast ja palusin, et Jumal toon nad läbi sellest olukorrast.
And through my time of prayer, the Lord spoke to me.
Ja sellel ajal, kui ma olin palves, isand rääkis minuga.
And the Lord spoke to me and said, all right, I want you to pay any lack that they have for the next year.
Ja isand ütles, et tead, ma tahan, et sa järgmise aasta jooksul maksatskid ise kinni kõik, mis iganes puudused neil oleks.
And so whatever's missing, whatever financial problems they're having, that I would stand up and say, okay, I will pay whatever is needed to keep you here and to keep you doing the work of God.
Et mis iganes rasvuse, mis iganes puudujäägid neil olid, et sina maksaksid kinni ise oma taskust, mis iganes neil puudu on.
And so I told Brenda and she said, okay, great, we'll do that. And she said, let's invite them over for dinner and let's tell them.
Ja siis ma rääksin Brendale oma abikaasale ja tema ütlesi, okay, väga hea, teeme nii ja kutsume nad lõunale ja räägime neile ka seda.
And we were really excited to tell them about what the Lord spoke to us to do and that God was going to come through and move for them.
Ja me olime väga põnevil selles suhtes, et kuidas Jumal saab kasutada meid, et aidata neid ja et rääkida neile sellest. Ja.
So whether they needed a couple hundred or a thousand, whatever it needed, we pledged to help them to stay in Estonia.
Et mida iganes neil oleks olnud vaja, kas paar sada krooni või paar tuhat krooni, et me oleksime aidanud neid.
And so they came over.
Ja siis nad tulid meile külla.
And I after dinner I said, well, we have something we want to share with you.
Ja pärast õhtuseki me siis nagu võtsime kokku ja ütlesime, kuule, et me tahaksime rääkida teiega.
And I told them what the Lord had spoken to me.
Ja ma rääksin neile, et seda sama asja, mida Jumal oli mulle rääkinud.
And the wife looked right at me and said this.
Ja naine vaatas mulle otsa ja ütles mulle niimoodi.
She said, no, we don't want money from you.
Ei, me ei taha raha teie käest.
We're believing the Lord to come through for us.
Me usume, et isand toob meid läbi.
And if the Lord doesn't provide for us, then we're just going to go.
Ja kui Jumal ei varusta meile, siis me lihtsalt läheb ära.
I didn't know what to say.
Ja tead, ma ei teanud, mida öelda sellises olukorras.
Because in my mind, this was the Lord providing for them.
Sest minu jaoks oli see nagu Jumal varustamast neid.
And she said, no, I don't want money from you. We're believing God.
Aga sa naine ütles, et ei, me ei taha raha sinu käest. Me usume, et Jumal toob meid läbi.
And obviously, this was not the way that she was expecting or believing God to provide her need.
Ja ilmselgelt see ei olnud see viis, kuidas tema uskus, et Jumal toob neid läbi või kuidas Jumal varustab neile.
Obviously, she wasn't expecting, you know, it to come from somebody in Estonia or me.
Ilmselgelt ta ei oodanud, et see õnnistus võiks tulla kuidagi kellegi eestlase või siis minu läbi.
And I don't know what she thought the Lord would do, but he's not going to send angels with money. He's going to use people.
Ja ma ei tea, mida see naine nagu ootas, et Jumal saab tegema, et Jumal ei saada ingleid rahakottidega, et näed, palun, ta saadab inimesi.
And I sat there just kind of in shocked silence for about 15 seconds.
Ja ma istusin seal umbes 15 sekundit täiesti šokeeritud või vaikuses seal.
And I just felt the Lord spoke to my heart and said, just don't push it. That was her chance.
Ja siis ma lihtsalt tundsin, et isand ütles, et okei, et ära hakka nüüd peale ka suruma, et see oli nende võimalus.
That was their answer.
Ja see oli nende vastus.
But now just let them go.
Aga nüüd luba neil minna.
She didn't want to receive it.
Et ta ei tahtnud seda vastu võtta.
And so I just said, well, okay, then, you know, we hope that the Lord comes through for you. What am I supposed to say?
Ja siis ma lihtsalt ütlesin, et no okei, et ma siis loodan, et Jumal varustab teile või toob teid läbi sellest.
Well, the end of that story is they ended up leaving Estonia.
No selle loo lõpp on selline, et nad lõpuks läksid Eestist ära.
And they're no longer in the full-time ministry.
Ja nad enam ei tegele täise aega teenistuses.
They're just helping out in a church somewhere.
Nad lihtsalt aidavad kuskil koguduses.
And that breaks my heart.
Ja mu süda on murdunud selles suhtes.
Because God could have blessed them and they could have stayed.
Sest Jumal oleks saanud õnnistada neid ja nad oleksid võinud jääda siia.
They were doing a good work here.
Nad tegid väga head tööd siin.
People were blessed by their ministry.
Inimesed said õnnistatud läbi nende töö siin.
But they gave up too easy.
Aga nad andsid alla liiga kergesti.
Because they were expecting it to come one way when the blessing was trying to come another.
Kuna nad üritasid saada õnnistatud ühtepidi, aga ei olnud vastu võtma seda nii, nagu see pidi tulema.
And they ended up blocking the blessing that God desired to do in their lives.
Ja lõpuks nad blokeerisid ära selle õnnistuse, mis oleks võinud tulla nende ellu.
And so I learned a lot on that day.
Ja sel päeval ma õppisin väga palju.
And you know, there have been times that I've looked back and I've wondered if I've ever blocked the blessings that God was trying to do for me.
Ja nagu kus ma olen mõelnud, et huvitav, kas ma ise olen ka enda elus blokeerinud ära Jumala õnnistusi, mis on üritanud tulla minu ellu.
Because I was expecting in a different way, maybe.
Sest ma ootasin, et võibolla Jumal teeb asju teistmoodi.
Maybe I was expecting it to come from the pastor, not just a normal person.
Võibolla mina ootasin, et õnnistused tulevad pastori käest, mitte tavaliste inimeste käest.
I want the pastor to give me a word, not Lona.
Ei, ma tahan, et pastor annaks mulle sõna, mitte Lona.
You know, and so maybe we missed the word from God because it came from a source that we weren't expecting.
Võibolla me panime Jumala sõnast mööda, kuna see sõna tuli kellegi teise kaudu, keda me ei oodanud, et võiks seda jagada meile.
You know, we were waiting for Tiit to come help us when Parto said, I'll be there. We said, no, I believe God will send somebody else.
Kui me ootame, et Tiit kuidagi aitaks meid, aga siis Parto ütleb, kuule, las ma aitan sind, ja siis ütleb, et ei, ma usun, et Jumala aitab mind teispidi.
You know, are there times that maybe we've not accepted the way that God wanted to bring the blessings into our lives?
Et kas on võimalik, et me oleme kuidagi ära blokeerinud Jumala õnnistused, mis oleks võinud tulla meie?
And I never want to be one who would turn away the answer when it shows up.
Ma ei taha olla selline inimene, kes nii-öelda palve vastuse saadab edurist minema, kui see on nagu tulemas mõellu.
And I don't want you to be the type of person that would block the blessing that God is trying to do in your life.
Ja ma ei taha, et sina oleksid selline, kes blokeerib ära Jumala õnnistuse nii-öelda tulemast oma ellu mingi
viisi. And you need to know that God will use people.
Ja sul on vaja teada, et Jumal kasutab inimesi.
But our faith is not in people.
Aga meie usk ei ole inimestes.
Our faith should be in God.
Meie usk peaks olema Jumalas.
If we say, God, I believe you, that Tuulika will bless me.
Kui me ütleme, et Jumal, ma usun, et sina õnnistab mind läbi Tuulika.
Then when Tuulika doesn't bless me,
et siis kui Tuulika ei õnnista mind,
and I'm saying, God, why didn't you move and tell her to bless me?
Siis ma ei lähe Jumala juurde, et Jumal, miks sa ei öelnud Tuulikale, et ta tuleks ja õnnistaks mind?
You know, when I first started in ministry, I was just coming to Estonia and I'm trying to raise money.
Sest tead, kui ma alles alustasin oma teenistusega ja olin tulemas siia Eestis teenida.
You know, and I'm, you know, raised enough money to buy my plane ticket, so I had my plane ticket.
Ja ma üritasin nagu raha kokku saada selleks, et ma saaksin oma lennupiletid ära osta, et tulla siia.
And this is way back in 1992.
Ja see oli ammu 92. aastal.
And so I'm saying, all right, God, you know, just speak to people's hearts and let the money come in.
Ja ma siis palusin, et jah, Jumal puuduta inimeste südameid ja et las see raha tuleb sisse.
And I didn't need much. I just needed enough just to survive. I just want to go.
Ja mul ei olnud palju vaja. Mul oli vaja lihtsalt piisavalt, selleks, et ellu jääda ja hakkama saada siin.
And I had a really rich uncle.
Ja mul oli üks väga rikas onu.
He's in heaven now, but at the time he was still living.
Ta on praegu taevas, aga siis ta oli veel siin.
And I thought, you know, he's got millions, and I wrote him a letter personally and told him what I was going to do.
Ja ma mõtlesin, et tema aitab mind ja me kirjutasin talle isiklikult kirja, et näin, ma lähen sellist asja tegema.
And so I said, you know, Uncle Art, this is my plan.
Ma kirjutasin, et onu Art, selline asi, et selline on minu plaan.
And this is what I want to do, and I'm trying to raise support.
Ja et ma tahan minna ja ma üritan enne minekut kokku ajada sellise nagu toetuse endale.
And if you could do anything to help me to be able to go and to do what God asked me to do, I would just be honored.
Et see oleks mulle au, kui sa kuidagi oleksid nõus toetama seda finantsiliselt, mida ma lähen tegema sinna, mida Jumal on kutsunud mind tegema.
He sent me a check. Do you know what a check is? Yeah, he sent me some money.
Ta saatis mulle checki, ehk siis natukene raha.
And it was $25.
See oli 25 dollarit.
20 euros.
20 eurot.
He's a millionaire.
Tal on miljonäärid pangas.
And here I'm, you know, I thought, I could, you know, he would want to help me.
Ja siin mina mõtlesin, et äkki ta tahab ikka aidata mind.
He could give me 10,000 and it doesn't even matter.
Ta oleks vabalt võinud anda 10,000 ja poleks mingisugust üldsegi liigutanud.
Man, I thought at least I would get a couple thousand. I didn't know, 100 at least, I don't know.
Ma ütlesin, vähemalt paar tuhat või ma ei tea, paar sada, mis iganes.
And $25.
Ja siis 25 dollarit.
And that was all.
See oli kõik kogu moos.
And he said, I hope you have a good trip. You didn't get it.
Ta ütles, et kuule, et ma loodan, et sul tuleb tore reis ja ta ei saanud pihta sellest.
And I was so disappointed.
Ja ma olin nii pettunud.
I was like, God, how am I going to go now?
Ma ütlesin, et Jumal, kuidas ma nüüd minna saan?
He was my shot. He was my chance to have money to go to Estonia.
Tema oli minu võimalus selleks, et ma võiksin üldse minna Eestisse.
God, what am I going to do now?
Jumal, mida ma nüüd teen?
I was trying to tell God how to get the blessing to me.
Ma üritasin öelda Jumalale, kuidas tema peab mind õnnistama.
I was like, God, go speak to Uncle Art and everything's going to be fine.
Ma ütlesin, Jumal, mine nagu räägi nüüd onu Artiga ja siis kõik läheb korda.
And Uncle Art, if you're listening to this message, yes, I'm talking about you.
Ja onu Art, kui sa kuulad mind praegu, siis jah, ma räägin sinust.
But he was He could have blessed me. He could have been the one to fund my whole ministry.
Aga ta oleks tõesti võinud aidata mind ja anna mulle hoo sisse.
He could have paid for everything.
Ta oleks võinud kõige eest maksta.
And he wouldn't even have known that he did it financially.
Ja ta poleks finantsiliselt vahetki arugi saanud, et toima aitasin sind.
He made movies. He had lots of money.
Ta tegi filme ja tal oli kõvasti pappi.
$25. And I was broken inside. I was like, well, maybe it's not God's plan for me to go.
Ma murdusin sisemiselt ja mõtlesin, et kuule, äkki see ei olegi Jumala plaan, et ma läheksin.
God, did I waste money in buying this stupid ticket?
Jumal, kas ma raiskasin raha selleks, et osta seda lennupiletitki?
I started turning on my faith.
Ma hakkasin nii-öelda oma enda usu vastu.
Because I was expecting the money to come this way. And God was like, no, 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 let's do it a different way.
Lihtsalt selle tõttu, et mina ootasin, et Jumal liigub ühte pidi, aga siis Jumal ütles, et ei, teeme hoopis nii.
I got another plan.
Mul on teine plaan.
You just trust me, I'm going to take care of you.
Sina lihtsalt usalda mind ja mina kannan hoolt sinu eest.
I'm so glad that happened.
Ja ma olen niivõrd tänulik, et see toimis.
Because if not, my faith would have been in Uncle Art.
Sest kui poleks, siis minu usk oleks ikkagi onu Artis olnud.
I would have had to ask Uncle Art for everything that I did.
Ma oleksin öelnud, et onu Art, kuule, toeta kõike, mida ma teen nüüd.
And that's not what the Bible says.
Ja see ei ole see, mida Piibel räägib.
Ask Uncle Art, and then he will provide all your needs according to his riches in earth.
Johannese 3:3, et onu Art täidab kõik sinu vajadused läbi oma rikkuse ja helluse.
No, that's not what the Bible says.
Ei, Piibel ei ütle sellist asja.
The Bible says trust in me.
Piibel ütleb, et usalda Jumalat.
Seek first the kingdom.
Otsi esimelt Jumala kuningriiki.
Seek me.
Otsi mind.
And I will provide for you.
Mina varustan sulle.
All that you need.
Kõike, mida sa vajad.
Man, I learned a big lesson.
Ma õppisin väga suure õppetunni.
And I'm sure glad I learned that early as I was starting to follow God with my life.
Ja ma olen nii tänulik, et ma õppisin selle nii vanakult, kui ma alles hakkasin nii-öelda teenima Jumalat.
And so what I did is I just began to pray.
Tead, mida ma tegin siis, ma hakkasin palvetama.
I just began to say, okay, God, I'll trust you to bring in these finances. I don't know how it's going to happen,
but I trust you. Ma hakkasin palvetama, et Jumal, ma usaldan sind. Ma ei tea, kuidas need finantsid tulevad, aga ma usaldan, et sina varustad.
I'm going to plan my life like I'm going. I'm going to go do what I believe you told me to do.
Ma plaanin oma elu, et ma olen minemas ja teen seda, mida sa palun mul teha.
And I trust you to take care of me.
Ja ma usun, et sina kannad hoolt minu eest.
And man, I just watched the money come in from different ones and different churches.
Ei tea, ma lihtsalt ühel hetkel nägin, kuidas rahakas tuleme ühes kogudusest teisest kogudusest.
And man, all of a sudden I had people supporting me $300 a month.
Ja üks hetk inimesed lihtsalt toetasid mind $300 kuus.
And it didn't come from one person.
Ja see ei tulnud ühe inimese käest.
And only $25 came from Uncle Art, not even monthly, just one time.
Ja ainult $25 tuli onu Arti käest ja see ei olnud mitte iga kuu, vaid ühe korra.
And so all of a sudden some other people that God began to speak to their heart, they said, Barry, we want to help you to go. We want to help you to stay.
Ühe hetkel inimesed hakkasid lihtsalt annetama ja ütlesid, et tead, Jumal lihtsalt rääkis meile, et me peaksime sind toetama.
And so I had $300 a month and I came to Estonia and God provided all I needed.
Ja ma tulin Eestisse ja tõesti Jumal varustas mind $300 iga kuu oli mul olemas, ma sain hakkama.
God has been so faithful to me from that time until now.
Jumal on väga hoostav minule sellest ajast peale kuni tänaseni.
And I've learned not to try to tell God the way to bless me.
Ma olen õppinud, et ma ei pea Jumalale ütlema, et kuidas täpselt tema peab mind õnnistama.
But just to trust that God would take care of me and all that I need.
Vaid lihtsalt usaldama, et Jumal kannab hoolt minu eest kõigest, mida ma vajan.
And I never want you to block the blessings that God is trying to do in your life.
Ma ei taha, et sina kuidagi blokeeriksid ära selle, mida Jumal saab sinu elus teha.
Don't block what God is trying to do for you.
Ära blokeeri ära seda, mida Jumal tahab teha sinu elus.
You need to know that God is going to use people to bless you.
Sul on vaja teada, et Jumal kasutab inimesi selleks, et õnnistada sind.
But our faith isn't in the people, our faith is in God.
Aga meie usk ei ole mitte nendes inimestes, vaid Jumalas.
And it's not always the way that you are going to be wanting it to happen.
Ja alati sa ei saa õnnistatud täpselt nii, nagu sa lootsid.
Now sometimes I've believed God for something and I thought it might happen a certain way and it did.
Ja on aeg, kus ma olen uskunud Jumalalt midagi ja olen mõelnud, kuidas see võiks nagu juhtuda ja need on juhtunud nii.
But more times than that, I've had it come in a different way and I'm like, wow, that had to be God.
Kõvasti rohkem kordi on olnud niimoodi, et ma olen saanud õnnistatud mingil viisil, mida ma poleks oodanudki.
And I found out that had to be God.
Ma mõtlesin, see pidi olema Jumal.
Because I wasn't even expecting that. How that happened?
Sest ma isegi ei oodanud, et midagi sellist juhtuks ja kuidas see nüüd juhtus.
And I've come to love it when God does it the way I didn't think.
Ja tead, ma täiega armastan seda, kui Jumal toob mind läbi sellistel viisidel, nagu ma ei oleks oodanud.
Because that is when I know it's God.
Sest sellisel hetkel, et ma tean, et see on Jumal.
And when it happens the way I think, I still know it's God.
Ja kui asjad toimuvad ka nii nagu ma olen oodanud, siis ma ikka tean, et Jumal on see, kes on varustanud.
But when it happens in even a different way, I stand in awe and I'm like, God, Your plan is better than mine.
Aga isegi kui läheb teisiti, kui ma olen oodanud, siis ma tean ikkagi, see on Jumalast ja ma tänan Jumalat ja ma lihtsalt inetan seda, mis on teinud.
So God is going to bless you, not always the way that you're wanting and not always the way you're expecting.
Jumal alati ei õnnista sind täpselt nii, nagu sina oled oodanud ja täpselt nii saab sündima, nagu sina oled tahtnud.
But if you will learn to stand and believe God,
aga kui sina õpid seisma ja uskuma Jumalat,
and then begin to act by faith,
ja siis hakkad tegutsema usu läbi,
you're going to see God will honor your faith and he will come through for you.
Siis sa näed, kuidas Jumal austab sinu usku ja hakkab sinu läbi tooma asjadest.
We need to learn to receive by faith in our lives.
Vaja õppida vastu võtma usu läbi.
And God will bless you abundantly if we can learn this lesson.
Ja kui me õpime selle õppetunni, siis Jumal võib õnnistada sind tõesti väga, väga suuresti.
And he's going to use other people in our lives to do it.
Ja ta kasutab selleks teisi inimesi meie elus.
Look here in Matthew chapter 21.
Vaatame siin Matteuse evangeeliumi 21. peatükki.
Matthew 21, I'm going to read verse 22 and I'm going to read this out of the New Living Translation.
Matteuse 21:22, ma loen selle New Living tõlkest.
It says you can pray for anything.
Sa võib paluda ükskõik mida.
And if you have faith, you will receive it.
Ja kui sul on usku, siis sa saad sellega vastu võtta.
So you could pray for anything.
Nii et sa võib paluda ükskõik mida.
If you have some scripture to back up that prayer.
Kui sul on selle palve nii-öelda toetuseks mingisugune kirjakoht.
Because you can't have faith unless you have some scripture that God promises to do it.
Sest kui sul ei ole Jumala sõnas mingit kohta, kuhu toetada, siis sa ei saa uskuda midagi Jumalat.
And it says you can pray for anything if you have faith.
Aga siin on öelda, et sa võid uskuda ükskõik mida, kui sul on usku selleks.
If you have the word of God, a promise from him for you.
Kui sul on Jumala sõnast tõotus, mis kehtib sinule.
And then you will receive.
Siis sa saad ka vastu võtta selle.
What it is that you believe God for.
Sa saad ka vastu võtta selle, mida sa oled uskunud Jumala.
This is Jesus saying this.
Jeesus ütles seda.
So you need to know, you can learn to take what belongs to you. Take what is yours.
Ja siis on vaja õppida nüüd vastu võtma seda, mis kuulub sulle.
Like this woman who pushed through to Jesus, she took the healing that was hers.
Nagu see naine, kes pressis läbi rahva hulgast, et vastu võtta Jeesuse käes seda, mis ta teadis, et kuulub talle.
Healing was available to everybody who was touching Jesus.
Tervenemine oli kättesaadav kõigile, kes Jeesus ümber oli ja katsusid teda.
If you read this story, it's the disciples turned to him and said, Jesus, everybody is trying to touch you. What do you mean, who's touching me?
Et Jeesus seal ütles, et kes puudutas mind ja apostlid ümber ringi ütlevad, kuule, kuidas sa küsid, kes puudutab sind? Kõik puudutavad sind.
You know, everybody in the city wants to say that they touched you.
Kõik siin linnas tahavad öelda, et kuule, ma puudutasin Jeesust.
But there was a touch of faith that took what belonged to her.
Aga Jeesus tundis seda, kuidas usu puudutas seda ja vägi läks välja temast.
And when you learn to take what belongs to you,
kui sina õpid vastu võtma seda, mis kuulub sulle,
whatever you ask for in prayer by faith,
mida iganes sa palud palves,
you will receive.
Seda sa saad ka vastu võtta.
If you have faith to act on that.
Kui sul on usku, mille najal tegutseda.
So we need to pray and we need to act and move to receive from God.
Ja me peaksime, we need to pray.
Pray and move.
Me peaksime palvetama ja ka tegutsema.
And we don't deserve it in ourselves. Remember that. This is not about you and how good you are. So you don't have to live a perfect life before God can bless you. How many are thankful for that? I know I am. You know, we don't have to be just little angels walking around the earth. But we do have to be doing the best we can for him. Him with all of our heart.
Aga me peame andma oma parima kogu oma südamest, et teenida Jumalat.
We need to be doing the best we can to the best of our ability.
Peame andma oma võimekuse kohaselt oma parima. Kõik, mis meil on.
If you get angry, if you say some things that you didn't really mean,
kui sa vihastud, kui sa pahandad, kui sa ütled asju, mida sa ei mõelnud tegelikult.
If you do some things you really didn't want to do.
Kui sa teed mingid asju, mida sa tegelikult ei tahtnud teha.
That's not going to void out the blessings of God.
Siis see ei elimineeri neid Jumala õnnistusi.
How many of you know God is a forgiving God?
Kui paljud teavad, et Jumal on andestav Jumal.
Amen. He is a loving God.
Ta on armastav Jumal.
He is patient.
Ta on kannatlik.
He's still got a plan.
Ta on ikkagi olemas plaan.
And if we will seek him, he will bless us.
Ja kui meie otsime teda, siis ta saab õnnistada meid.
So it's not about what we deserve.
Nii et asi ei ole selles, mida me väärime.
It's about Jesus.
Vaid asi on Jeesus.
And what he's provided.
Ja selles, mida tema on varustanud.
He doesn't have to go to the cross anymore for you.
Jeesus ei pea enam sinu pärast minema tagasi ristile.
He's already died and rose again.
Ta juba suri ja ta juba tõusis üles.
He's already paid for your blessing.
Ta on juba maksnud ka sinu õnnistuseks.
So now go take what belongs to you in Christ.
Ja võta vastu see, mis kuulub sulle Kristuses.
Because it belongs to you.
See kuulub sulle.
But we access those blessings by faith.
Aga me pääseme ligi nendele õnnistustele usu läbi.
So by faith we take what Jesus has provided.
Ja usu läbi me võtame vastu selle, millega Jeesus on meid varustanud.
But don't take what is not yours.
Aga ära võtta seda, mis ei kuulu sulle.
Don't take what does not belong to you.
Ära võtta seda, mis ei kuulu sulle.
Don't covet your neighbor's possessions.
Ära ihalda, ära himusta oma naabri vara.
Don't say, I believe God that I can have your car. Thank you very much.
Ära ütle, et Jumal, ma usun, et mul saab selle tüübi auto olema.
You know, or I like your drapes. I'm going to take them for myself because pastor said to take what is mine.
Ei, kuule, tead, mulle väga meeldivad need kardinad, mis sul on, ja ma võtan need kardinad endale, sest pastor ütles, et ma pean võtma selle, mis kuulub mulle.
That's not what I'm talking about.
Ma ei räägi sellest.
I'm talking about walking in faith in God, knowing He's going to provide.
Ma mõtlen seda, et sa käid usus ja
knowing God's going to provide.
Teades, et Jumal varustab sind.
So don't take what doesn't belong to you, but you can believe God for your own.
Nii et ära võtta seda, mis ei kuulu sulle, aga usu Jumalalt, et tema varustab sind.
But know this, if God has blessed somebody else, that God can bless you too.
Aga pea meeles ka seda, et kui Jumal on kedagi õnnistanud, siis Jumal saab ka sind seda õnnistada.
If God has blessed somebody else with something nice, God can bless you with something
Jumal
nice.
Jumal on õnnistanud kedagi teist millegi kenaga, siis Jumal saab sind õnnistada millegi kenaga.
And you're going to become what you believe for in your future.
Ja sa võid saada selleks, mida sa usud oma tuleviku suhtes.
What you believe in God today is what you're going to have in the months to come.
Sest see, mida sa usud täna Jumala käest, selleks sa saad siin kuude tulekul.
And you need to stretch your faith.
Ja sul on vaja pingutada oma usku.
Get ready to receive big things from God.
Valmistu vastu võtma suuri asju Jumala käest.
Knowing that God's not done with you yet.
Teades, et Jumal ei ole sinuga üldse
veel mitte lõpetanud. God's plan is still going forward. There's more for you to do.
Jumala plaan on edasi liikumas ja on veel palju asju, mis vajab tegemist.
So we're not only to ask by faith, but we receive by faith.
Ja me üksnes ei pea uskuma.
We don't just ask. And you know, I want us to look at another example. We got time for one more here. Another example of somebody receiving by faith. And here's this leper in Matthew chapter 8. And Jesus had just finished a sermon. There was thousands of people there with him.
Jeesus oli just lõpetanud jutluse ja seal olid tuhanded inimesed ümber ringi.
He's coming down from the mountain.
Ta tuleb mäelt alla.
And so let's pick it up here in Matthew chapter 8 verse 1.
Et hakkame siin vaatama Mattiuse 8 esimeses peatükki esimeses salmist.
When Jesus came down from the mountainside, large crowds followed him.
Kui siis Jeesus tuli mäelt alla, järgnesid talle suured rahva hulgad.
And a man with leprosy came and knelt before him and said, "Lord, if you are willing, you can make me clean."
Ja vaata, tema juurde astus pidalitõbiline, kummardas teda ja ütles, isand, kui sa tahad, siis sa võid mu puhtaks teha.
Now you got to understand what's going on here.
Saa aru sellest, mis siin toimub.
This man was waiting to ambush Jesus when he came down the mountain.
See mees nii-öelda varitses Jeesus, kui Jeesus oli mäest ala tulemas.
He's probably hiding in the bushes, so nobody saw him.
Narratasti varitses seal põõsas, kust keegi teda ei näinud.
Because if anybody saw him, he was going to be thrown in prison.
Sest kui keegi oleks näinud teda, siis ta oleks vangikongi visatud.
Because he was a leper, and it was illegal for him to leave the little colony they set up for him.
Sest ta oli pidalitõbine ja pidalitõbiseid hoiti eraldi kolonias teisest eemale, et inimesed ei nakataks.
They would have either killed him or thrown him in a prison.
Ja kui teda oleks nähtud, siis ta oleks kas ära tapetud või ta oleks vangikongi visatud.
And so this man is waiting for Jesus, and he's watching him come, and he's behind the bush.
Nii et see mees peidab ennast ja ootab, kuni Jeesus tuleb mäest alla.
And when Jesus is close enough, he steps out from behind the bush, walks up to him, and kneels down before him.
Ja kui Jeesus läheneb talle, siis ta tuleb põõsa tagant välja ja kummardub tema ees.
And here Jesus is coming down this mountain, and behind him is thousands of people following him.
Ja siin Jeesus tuleb mäest alla ja tema selja taga on tuhanded inimesed.
And everybody's like, oh, that's a leper.
Ja kõik vaatavad, kuule, see on pidalitõbine.
What is he doing?
Mida ta oma arust teeb?
What is he doing there? Get away from Jesus!
Mida sa ometi teed siin? Kao ära Jeesuse juurest.
You know, what are you doing?
Mida sa omarust teed?
Jesus just looked at him with those eyes of love.
Jeesus vaatas talle nende armastavate silmadega otsa.
And look here in verse 3.
Ja vaatasid kolmandast salmist.
Says that Jesus reached out his hand and touched the man.
Jeesus sirutas käe välja, puudutas teda ja ütles.
He said, "I am willing, be clean."
Ma tahan, saa puhtaks.
And immediately the man was cleansed of his leprosy.
Ja ta sai otse kohe oma pidalitõvest puhtaks.
This is the love of God.
Selline on Jumala armastus.
This is the power of God that's available to us all.
Selline on Jumala vägi, mis on meile kõigile kätte saadav.
If we would approach Jesus by faith.
Kui meie läheme Jeesuse juurde usu läbi.
If we would learn to take what belongs to us by faith.
Kui me õpime vastu võtma seda, mis kuulub meile usu läbi.
This man should not even have been in public.
See mees ei oleks pidanud olema üldsegi avalikuse ees.
It was illegal. But he believed something. He believed he was the Messiah. Believed he was the Son of God. Believed if I could just get his attention, he's going to heal me of this disease. And he waited and he saw him. And he said, okay, this is my chance. And so I'm either going to be healed or I'm going to be killed. And either way, I'm fine with it because I don't want to live like this anymore. I don't want to just waste away. So he's either going to heal me or they're going to kill me. I don't care. But I believe he's the Messiah. And if he loves me, he will heal me. If he's willing, I know he can. I know he is able. I've heard of how he's healed other lepers, just like me. And if he loves me, if he cares about me, I'm going to go take what is available. He stopped the crowd and he probably took the air out of the crowd when he kneels before Jesus. What's happening? And then we see Jesus reach out and touch him. Now, I don't believe Jesus kind of touched him. Right? It's like, okay, be healed.
Okay, so there.
No, I believe it was a sign of love and compassion. I believe that Jesus maybe just wrapped his arms around the guy.
He
said, I'm willing. Be healed. Because how long had it been since anybody wanted to touch this man? Because pieces of his body are falling off because of this terrible disease. How long it had been since anybody showed any love to this man.
And
we all know how important the human touch is.
And
he hadn't had it for a long time. And I believe that Jesus hugged the man.
And
said, I am so willing. I thank you for your faith.
Because
today you're healed. And it said immediately the leprosy left the man. I don't know if his nose grew back or whatever, but the leprosy itself was gone. But Jesus' touch was a touch of love. It was a touch of power. It was a touch of healing.
And
this touch broke any barriers that were in this man's life. And then the Bible says that he just followed Jesus along the road with everybody else. Isn't that awesome? Man, I just absolutely love everybody. You know, isn't it just kind of the crowd mentality?
It's
like, oh, don't touch him. And then once Jesus touches him and heals the guy, they're like, ah, oh, come on, you can be with us. Yeah, we're glad you can be part of us now. But this is the kind of thing that's available to everyone who would have the faith to move. Those thousands of people had faith in their heart, but they didn't move. The faith that makes you move is the faith that's ready to receive. The faith that takes you to that new place. The faith that makes you to move to that promise of God. That's the faith to receive. I want us to be an active powerful church because we serve an active, powerful God.
Ma tahan, et me oleksime aktiivne ja väeline kogudus, sellepärast et me teenime aktiivselt ja väelist Jumalat.
And this man had to go past any culture to receive.
Ja see mees pidi minema mööda igasugusest kultuurist ja asjadest selleks, et vastu võtta.
And he knew that Jesus could heal him. He just didn't know if he would.
Ja ta teadis, et Jeesus saab tema terveks teha, ta ei teanud, kas ta teeb lihtsalt.
And Jesus told him, I can and I will.
Ja ta ütles, et ma saan ja ma tahan.
Because I promised.
Sest ma olen tõotanud.
And Jesus would tell you the same thing.
Ja Jeesus ütleks sulle täpselt sama.
When you have his promise and you're not sure, is this for me?
Kui sul on tema tõotus ja sa ei ole kindel, kas see kuulub sulle.
His words to this man is his words to you.
Jeesuse sõnad sellele mehele on sõnad sinule.
I can.
Ma saan.
And I will.
Ja ma tahan.
I can and I will.
Ma tahan ja ma teen.
I can and I will.
Ma saan ja ma tahan.
I will do this for you.
Ma teen seda sinu jaoks.
I will show up for you.
Ma ilmutan ennast sinu jaoks.
If you'll just believe and act on what you believe.
Kui sa üks need usud, ja tegutseb vastavalt sellele usule.
All things are possible.
Kõik asjad on võimalikud.
This man risked his life and was completely healed.
See mees riskis oma eluga ja ta sai täielikult terveks.
Our God is faithful.
Sest meie Jumal on ustav.
Amen. He is so faithful.
Ta on väga ustav.
And I hope you make it easy for God to be able to bless you.
Ja ma loodan, et sa teed selle lihtsaks, et Jumal saab sind õnnistada.
I hope it's easy for you to receive from God.
Loodan, et see on sinu jaoks lihtne vastu võtta Jumal käest.
I want you to grow to a place that your faith is so active that you're expecting God to show up day by day.
Ma tahan, et sinu usk oleks niivõrd aktiivne, et igapäevaselt sa ootad, et Jumal ilmutab ennast.
And that you're not always just thinking about it, but that you're acting on it.
Ja et sa alati mitte üksnes ei mõtle selle peale, vaid et sa tegutsed ka vastavalt
sellele. Don't just think about his goodness. Trust him and act on his goodness.
Ära lihtsalt mõtle sellele, kuivõrd hea Jumal on, vaid tegutse ja räägi vastavalt sellele.
And wait for God to come through for you in unusual ways.
Ja ole valmis ootama, et Jumal toob sind läbi üleloomulikudel viisil.
And I love to receive blessings.
Ja mulle väga meeldib Jumala käest õnnistusi vastu võtta.
And I've learned that some of them are found in the craziest times.
Ja ma olen avastanud, et väga paljud nendest õnnistusest tulevad väga hullumeelsetel aegadel.
Times when it doesn't seem like you should have, God shows up and blesses you and say, here.
Aegadel, kui tundub, et sul ei peaks mingisugust õnnistust olema, Jumal tuleb ja lihtsalt vaatab välja ja õnnistab sind.
Because you've trusted me, because you're walking this out.
Sa oled usaldanud teda ja sa oled kõndinud koos temaga.
I'm going to show you how good I am.
Ja selle tõttu Jumal ütleb, et ma näitan, kui hea ma olen.
You keep believing me, I'll keep releasing my power. That's the promise of God.
Kui sina jätkuvalt usud minusse, siis ma valan välja oma väe sinu ellu.
And so God will do anything.
Jumal teeb saab teha ükskõik mida.
If we could just find his promise.
Kui meie üksnes leiame tema tõotuse.
Stand on the word.
Ja seisame Jumala sõnal.
And believe it's for me too.
Ja usume, et see kuulub ka minule.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Would you stand and let me pray for you tonight?
Tõusame palun koos püsti ja palutaks.
Hallelujah. Father, I love you so much.
Isa, ma armastan sind nii väga.
I thank you for your word. I thank you that your word's true for us.
Tänasin sinu sõna eest. Ma tänan, et sinu sõna on tõene meie jaoks.
I thank you that all things are possible if we would just believe.
Ma tänan, et kõik on võimalik lihtsalt kui me usume.
And Lord, I pray that even tonight, that you're helping us to shore up some of our double-mindedness. That we would put the word of God in first place. And that we'd begin to act like your word is true. That we'd begin to take what belongs to us.
And
we'd begin to receive your abundant blessings. That we would know that it's your hands. And I just thank you, Father, for providing for us in abundant ways. Thank you that you are so good to your people. And I pray that the world would look at us and that they would be jealous of our God. And I pray, Father, that what you do through us, that it would draw others to you.
And
so our heart's cry is, Lord, use us for your glory. Use us in our lives to do something great. Use this church for your glory. Use your church to do something great in this city. Lord, that we would be able to help people. And help people to find you. Help people to know what belongs to them in Christ Jesus. Lord, use us. And we just thank you for it. And we give you praise and glory. Holy Spirit, continually remind us this week of what the Lord spoke to us tonight. And help us have some courage to step out and act in faith.
Ja aita meil, et meil oleks julgust ja et meil oleks usku, et käia seda oma elus.
So that we can receive the great blessings of God. We thank you for all these things in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. Did you get something out of it? Glory to God. Well, did anybody have a prayer request? Something that we could just pray and believe God with you for?